And welcome back to the Queens Athletic and Recreation Center. Bill Miklas, along with Peter Reimer, as the men's Gaels open their OUA regular season with a home game against the Lakehead Thunderwolves, the team that did very well nationally a year ago. They're starting five getting introduced, and I'll bring Peter into the conversation right away. Gaels, very successful season last year under Stephen Barry. They're young. This is a Lakehead team that's seen how close they can get to the national prize. This is going to be a nice matchup to open the season.
Yeah, I think it's going to be really interesting to see how the Gaels come out and play against this experienced Lakehead squad. And a team that's had success the last few years against a team that's really just building themselves up in the Gaels.
And, of course, leading the Gaels is Greg Faulkner, the transfer from Carleton. Last year we saw what he could do. He got hurt late in the regular season. That hurt the Gaels. They fell in the standings, but they really go as far as he takes them.
Yeah, it's true. Last year he did suck that concussion late in the year, and it's nice to see him back. He played well through the preseason, and you're right. It's really how well he plays determines how well the Gaels will play.
Gaels will start Roshane Roberts and Supreet Singh in the backcourt, along with Ryle Strood, the aforementioned Faulkner, and Nikola Misjensevich, who's got the ball here for three, misses, and the rebound away come the Thunderwolves. This is Henry Tan driving. He misses. Singh with the rebound, hounded, and recovers to get the ball. The other starters for Lakehead: Anthony McIntosh, Igor Labov, Dwayne Harvey, and Justin Bell. Mislencevic stolen by Harvey. Harvey into the front court. This is Labov. Swung around. Harvey. Labov drives on Roberts. Spins on Roberts. Beautiful feed. And the slam home by McIntosh. Layup, Mislencevic, and we're tied. I'll struggle with that name all season like I did last year. Tam, McIntosh. And he traveled. So his first play was an emphatic dunk. His second play is a turnover. Singh, Stroud, Faulkner, bit of a weave, Singh for three, too strong, Stroud loses out to Bell, and Tan will bring it up. 2-2, we're a minute 40 into this one. Roberts almost with the steal, Tan fights him off, hands off to Harvey. Harvey with a pick from McIntosh, rolls over Singh, got his own rebound, kicks it out, Roberts comes away with it. Roberts puts up the floater. That misses. Roberts, loose ball, still on the floor. And jump ball, and the possession will belong to Lakehead. So scrambling play early on here, Peter.
Yeah, really back and forth. A lot of turnovers so far. I think it might be the team that gets under control and keeps the ball most that comes out at least early on in the lead.
Head coach Matt Erdman of Lakehead telling Henry Tan what to call. McIntosh. Hands off to Labov. Labov drives, cut off by Faulkner. Pull up from the foul line. Misses. Rebound, Gaels. Singh. Harvey trying to slow him down. Nice feed to Stroud. Stroud turns. Baby hook. Too strong. And Lakehead will walk it up the floor. So the Gaels are getting looks early on. Faulkner tried to steal it from Tam. Bell fell but got it to Labov. He misses the three. Harvey follows the rebound. Can't hit. Mislencevic ahead. Faulkner cut off by Tam. Tried to kick it out to Roberts. Quick hands by Labov.
Yeah.
Pan. Harvey. McIntosh drives, kicks it out. Tan, left-handed three, in and out. And a body on the ground, Stroud, and that's because of a foul on Lakehead, I believe McIntosh. So McIntosh has been heavily involved here in this first quarter. He scored Lakehead's points on a dunk. Take that back, it was Bell. Justin Bell got the foul. Faulkner up to Roberts. Milencevic. Turns, kicks it out, Faulkner for three, no, Stroud had the rebound knocked away from him by Harvey. Labov drives baseline, cut off, up top, Tam spins on Roberts. Labov drives, too strong a pass, another Lakehead turnover.
Not sure if you can say it's been all defense here with the score 2-2, or if it's just been sloppy offense to get things going.
Singh, cut off by Harvey, tried to force a baseline pass to Faulkner. Kicked out of bounds, 16 left on the shot clock, 6:02 left first quarter, and we're still tied at the bucket each. Roberts, hand off to Singh. Stroud, Singh, bobbled it a bit, feeds Stroud. Stroud goes up over Tam, Gaels lead 4-2.
That's a matchup that the Gaels will take all day, Stroud down low over a guard.
Harvey. McIntosh. Tam. Harvey. Bell wanted it inside. Harvey cut off baseline, and he stepped out of bounds. Good defense by the Gaels. And that's going to get the first sub of the game. Number 8, Nathan Wainwright comes in for Harvey. Stroud. Milencevic. Roberts, Faulkner, charge, Labov drew it, he was setting him up for it, Faulkner doesn't like the call.
Head coach Stephen Berry of the Gaels also looking on in disbelief after that offensive foul called against Faulkner.
Bell. Turns on Stroud, left-hander, got it. We're tied at 4. Roberts drives on Labov, hangs, floater, Gaels lead.
No play there for the Gaels, just pure athleticism from Roberts.
Past the midway point of this first quarter. Teams still feeling each other out. McIntosh. Left-handed hook, got it. That's a nice move.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for the Gaels to play defense if he can hit that consistently.
Roberts, crossover by Tam. Floater, hits the rim, but it was a pass to himself. Milencevic for three, got it.
Milencevic is a deceiving three-point threat. Led the Gaels last year in shooting, in three-point shooting percentage, and was near the top of the OUA for shooting percentage.
Tam stumbles, has to pick up his dribble, and that's double dribble. And he's coming off, I think. Some struggles for Henry Tam the last minute or so. And on comes number 20, Nolan McKenzie.
For the Gaels, number 12, Andrew Matthews is on the court.
And also number 21, Alexandra Robichaud. And he replaced Labov. Singh. Under 4 left first quarter. Gaels by 3. Mackenzie Simpson has checked into the game for the Gaels. As has the man with the ball, Andrew Mavity. Simpson, and he's blocked from behind by Bell. But this might be number 2 on Justin. And Lakehead might be in some trouble early in this first quarter as Brent Wallace, the freshman out of Brisbane, Australia, all 7 feet tall of them, will come in for Bell. Simpson hits the first free throw.
Yeah, it's got to be a nice addition for Lakehead. I mean, every team in Canadian university basketball can use height. 7 feet, about as tall as they get.
Well, he's actually the shortest player, or short, not the tallest player on the team. Andrew McCarthy out of Massachusetts at 7'1", third year visual arts student, hasn't checked into the game yet. Both free throws made. It's a 5-point Gaels lead. McIntosh hangs, misses the bank. Singh with the rebound. And he'll bring it up the floor. Simpson. Up top, Faulkner. Stroud. Hand off to Faulkner. Faulkner pulls up for two. Won't fall. Loose ball. Simpson. Layup. Fell right into his lap.
Head coach Stephen Barry going into this game highlighted rebounds, and especially offensive rebounds, is one of the keys to getting them to win. He'll like to see that from Mackenzie Simpson.
Three-pointer by Wainwright. Quiets the Queens crowd a bit. Makes it 13-9. Faulkner. Simpson fumbled the pass. Pull-up jumper. Too strong. Rebound Stroud. Doing a great job on the offensive boards, like Peter said seconds ago. Singh for two, too strong. Rebound controlled by the big fella Wallace. McKenzie, Robichaud. McKenzie drives, tried to force a pass, Faulkner, and he was grabbed by McKenzie, so another Lakehead foul. As Labov and now the other 7-footer, McCarthy, will check into the game, and Wallace and McIntosh, I believe, are coming out. So we won't see the two 7-footers on the floor at the same time.
Coming onto the court for the Gaels, too, their first year, Mike Shoveler. He's their tallest guy, so I think they're looking to match up the height there. He's 6'11".
Son of former Gael Bruce Shoveler, who I remember doing CFRC games of, not to date myself. Mavity for three. Got it. Lakehead switched the pick, and Mavity made them pay. And it's a 4-point Gaels lead. Actually make it a 7-point lead, as they gave the points to the wrong side at first. So that equals the Gaels' biggest lead of the quarter. Mavity almost with the steal. Nice feed and a foul on Faulkner, and now he's got two as he stopped McCarthy from the dunk. But unfortunately, the Gaels' outstanding fourth-year player will have to go to the bench. And I think he's still upset about the first one he got.
Yeah, the Gaels can't afford to have Greg Faulkner stepping out of the game because of foul trouble.
McCarthy misses the first free throw. Noise being brought in the front row at center court by some Gaels fans dressed up as pirates. And a line violation on Lakehead. McCarthy, I believe, he stepped in to get the ball, I think, is what they're telling Coach Erdman.
I think it was McKenzie was in there early. Too many Lakehead players were in.
And now they're changing the call, which of course Stephen Barry wants to know about. And he gets the explanation and seems content with it. I don't think happy. McCarthy almost broke the backboard with that one. Misses them both. 1:25 time left first quarter. And now Halsabar has checked into the game at point guard for the Gaels. Simpson kicks it out, swung around. Milencevic cut off by Labov. Has Labov on his back, wants to turn him around. Kicks it back out. Mavity with seven on the shot clock. Mavity kicks it out. Halsabar for three. Got it. Gaels lead by 10.
He may not be the biggest player on the floor at 5'11", but he can sure shoot the ball.
Haslabar with the three, and the Gaels by double digits. Inside, McCarthy forces it up. Shoveler with the rebound and good defense. Haslabar. Mavity thought about the three. Haslabar. Hand off to Mavity. Up top, Milencevic. Under 30 seconds left, first quarter. Eight on the shot clock. Shoveler, handoff. Mavity for three. No. And Lakehead can hold on for the last shot. McKenzie brings the ball up the floor. McKenzie and Shoveler was a little late in getting there and picks up the cheap foul. Stroud will come back in for Shoveler. And returning are McIntosh and Harvey, and in for the first time, Jamar Cote for Lakehead. And in for the first time for the Gaels, Patrick Street, who takes out Mackenzie Simpson, who had some good minutes there. 16.2 seconds left, first quarter, and Lakehead will hold for the last shot. Gaels will go into the end of the quarter with a lead. Will it be double digits? Harvey, the ball fumbled it and traveled. 3.2 seconds left on the Lakehead turnover. And sloppy play in this first quarter from the visitors. Haslabar up to Stroud. Haslabar shoots it at the buzzer. No. Gaels lead 19-9 after the first quarter. And Peter have to be pleased with the way they've played so far.
Yeah, the Gaels coming out with a double-digit lead against the good Lakehead squad after one quarter. I don't think Stephen Berry can be too upset about many things, but one thing he'll surely want to see out of his Gaels team is a few less turnovers. They managed to calm things down at the end of the quarter, but at the start of the game, things were a little too hectic and they didn't have enough control.
And as you said early on in the first quarter, the Gaels really wanted to do well on the offensive boards against a very athletic Lakehead team. They have. Now Falkner's on the bench with two fouls. Do we see him again in the second quarter?
I think we will. I don't think we'll see him to start the second quarter, but I think probably around 6 minutes we'll see him back into the game, and then hopefully for the Gaels, he doesn't pick up another foul.
So the Gaels will play 12. We'll play well tomorrow night. That'll be our next QTV Live sports broadcast. Basketball action. Women's game at 6, and the men's game tipping off a little after 8. In that first quarter, some stats to throw your way. Just 9 points from Lakehead. McIntosh with 4, Wainwright with the 3. And Bell with 2 for the Gaels. Balanced scoring. No one with more than 5. Milencevic with the 5. Simpson with 4. Mavity, Haslabar, both with 3s. And Stroud and Roberts with a bucket each. The Gaels had 4 turnovers to Lakehead 6. And out-rebounded Lakehead 10-8. But 4-2 on the offensive glass. So doing exactly what you said, Peter, they need to do if they hope to win this basketball game.
Yeah, Lakehead is a little bit taller than the Queens Gaels overall, but the Gaels obviously putting the effort in to get the rebounds they need.
Haslabar to Stroud. Hand off to Milencevic, gets the pick, drives, fouled by McCarthy. Foot speed right away, you see on the 2 7-footers, not their strength, and Milencevic got him to try and keep up with them.
Yeah, I mean, Milencevic is probably going to win that battle every time when they're moving quickly.
And he'll go to the line for 2. Roll in the first. Hits both. It's a 12-point Gaels lead at 21-9. Harvey. McIntosh. Guarded by Mavity. Hand off to Cope. They want to get it inside to McIntosh. They do. Three on the shot clock. Turnaround jumper misses. Pass LeBar away. Can't get by Koch, and so it'll be a secondary break. Street from long range. Got it!
That's one thing that he's been doing well all through the preseason. Didn't get many minutes last season, but he's been shooting the ball very well so far this year, and that's what the Gaels need from him.
And the Gaels lead by 15. Nice split by Harvey. Kicks it out to Koch for three. Too strong. Rebound. McIntosh wanted to dunk it. Lost it, but it still went in. He was lucky there. That silences a mini Gaels run. Street. They're not going to leave him alone for a three anymore. Kicked out. Pass LeBar. Mavity for three. Got it!
That's Lakehead timeout. Yeah, it's one of the difficult things of playing the Gaels team is that if you cover one of their shooters, they always have more shooters on the floor.
And they moved the ball quickly that time to get it to the open shooter. The extra pass by Passlebar got Mavity open. He hits another three, and now they're up 16.
Yeah, Mavity's second three of the game, and he can shoot the ball. Patrick Street can shoot the ball. Packlebar can shoot the ball. Difficult matchup for the Lakehead team. They're going to have to be running at almost all of the Gaels players on the floor.
Now, the timeout by Coach Erdman to talk about that, I'm sure, and about things at the offensive end. But I would ask you, the drawback now with getting out on the shooters, the Gaels have some quick big guys that can drive.
It's true. That's what the Gaels have prided themselves on, is shooting and quickness. So it makes for a difficult matchup against any team.
So the first timeout called in this game by Lakehead. Wallace returns for McCarthy. Tam is also back into the game. McIntosh, Harvey, and Coke are the other players on the floor for Lakehead. For the Gaels, it's Street, Packlebar, Stroud, Mavity, and Ms. Lencevich. And Lakehead up the floor, down 16, 27, 11, as you see on your screen. Harvey. McIntosh. McIntosh again. Harvey. They're looking inside, but good defense right now by Stroud. Wallace misses the bank. Harvey got the rebound. He misses. Got it again and was fouled from behind by Stroud. Good hustle by Harvey. If the Gaels could have corralled a rebound, there was a chance to extend the lead more as Singh will come in for Packlebar. I think Harvey was beating him on the glass there.
Yeah, that's one area where Packlebar is not as fortunate, is under the glass.
Harvey hits the first. Just underway in the second quarter. Gaels leading 27-12 over the Lakehead Thunderwolves. Bill Nicholas along with Peter Reimer and the entire QTV's crew as Harvey gets one of two. Into the front court. Street. Swung around to Ms. Lencevich. Mavity. Street. Ms. Lencevich. Five on the shot clock. Drives. Cut off. Singh. Nice. Head fake. And puts in the floater with one on the shot clock.
Lakehead doing a better job of running at the Gaels shooters there, but Singh finding a way around his man and getting the ball into the basket.
And an offensive foul called here on Wallace, who shoved Stroud aside. And Lakehead is getting frustrated. Especially their big guys. And with the Gaels' quickness, you would wonder if that's going to take the seven-footers out of this game.
That's certainly one thing that the Gaels would be happy about.
Stroud. Ms. Lencevich. Street. Brings it to Singh. Inside, Ms. Lencevich, and that's off his leg. I think the Gaels thought maybe there should be a foul on McIntosh, but when there's no foul called, it definitely the ball went off Ms. Lencevich's leg. So that's a big stop there for Lakehead, because they could have fallen behind by more. Harvey. McIntosh. runs over Mislencevic and picks up the charge.
Mislencevic was petitioning the call earlier, but gave up the argument there and decided to show his worth on the court instead. A smart decision.
First foul on McIntosh. Lakehead picks up full court. And Mavity will be forced to bring the ball up the floor. Steal by Tam, steal back by Mavity. Lakehead, great save by Koch to Tam, but he missed the layup. Mislencevic the other way, blocked by Wallace, but he'll pick up his second foul and he'll go to the bench. And back in will come Bell, and Roberts is going to come back into the game for the Gaels to give them some more ball handling.
Gaels substitution.
Quite a turn of events there for the Lakehead Thunderwolves as they corralled the ball eventually but weren't able to put it in the net. I guess almost nothing going their way at this moment.
Mislencevic missed the first. And goes 0 for 2. So it stays at a 17-point Gaels lead. Under 7 minutes left, first half. Roberts is guarding Tam now. Almost made the steal, but Tam left alone for three. Misses. And a foul on Stroud. If it's his, it's his second. And now a little bit of foul trouble here for the Gaels. They're two big post guys. Stroud and Faulkner both on the bench with two. Shoveler comes in. Harvey. Gets a pick. Splits. Feeds McIntosh, who's fouled. He'll go to the line for two. And Mackenzie Simpson picks up his first.
Yeah, a couple fouls on the more experienced Gaels. The big guys for the Gaels. Puts a lot of pressure on Mike Shoveler as a first year.
McIntosh hits the first. He's got 6 points. Sorry, 7 points, looking for his eighth. And a chance to cut the lead to 14. Or 15, sorry. And he does. Roberts. Tougher defense here by Lakehead. Singh, and that's an offensive foul on Shoveler, and he's got two.
Big guys on both sides of the floor picking up fouls left and right here.
Foul called on the Gaels.
And Lakehead getting repeated stops here and opportunities to cut into the big Gaels lead. Swung around, three-pointer Wainwright, in and out, rebound Bell. Missed it. Mislencevic pulls down the rebound. Great chance there for Lakehead that they can't capitalize on. Singh almost threw it away. Mislencevic chases it down with 12 on the shot clock. Roberts, 8 on the shot clock. Gets a pick, fires up a three, misses. Bell rebound. Outlet to Harvey. Koch, Harvey. There, gives to Wainwright. Harvey. Bell wants it inside. Koch tried to feed it to him. Singh couldn't hang on to the steal. And Lakehead maintains possession with 5 seconds left, and Street returns to the game for Mislencevic.
Mislencevic coming off the floor with a bit of a limp there. If he goes down injured, that's very concerning for the Gaels losing big men.
And Lakehead forgot about the shot clock. They got a shot off from Koch from almost mid-court. But the Gaels come away with the rebound. Roberts, man slipped, and he lays it in.
Great quickness there by Roberts to get by his man and get to the basket.
The Gaels lead again by 17. Midway through the third quarter. Wainwright bumped by Shoveler, and he stepped out of bounds. Wainwright thought he was bumped enough that it should have been a foul on Shoveler. Official Johnny Besseling didn't see that and made the call. Didn't agree with that, I should say. Not that he didn't see it. Didn't think it was a foul. Roberts. Street. Shoveler. Hand off to Singh. Fakes the three. Drives on Harvey and draws the foul. So Harvey picks up his first. It's the 15th foul, so Gaels are shooting the bonus now, and their next foul, Queens as that is, will send Lakehead to the line for bonus. Singh hits the first. Gets both. It's a 19-point Gaels lead. Wainwright. McIntosh. Kicks it out. Tam swings it. Harvey for three. Got it. Good ball movement, and it started with the kick out by McIntosh, and Stephen Berry saw something right away and called timeout. Shoveler's in trouble in that matchup, Peter, with the two fouls against a veteran like McIntosh.
Yeah, it's going to be difficult for, it's always difficult for a first year to find their footing this early in the season. And Shoveler's jumped right into a game against a quality opponent. Certainly not an easy way to start your OUA career, but I think he's playing pretty well so far. I think probably Stephen Berry will like what he's seen from him overall.
So Gaels leading 33-17 in their regular season opener. Bill Nicholas along with Peter Reimer. There's a look at the Pirates in the front row cheering on the Gaels and trying to get in to the heads of the Lakehead Thunderwolves. Timeout. Singh against full court pressure by Lakehead. We approach the last 4 minutes of the first half. Roberts almost stripped by McIntosh. Simpson tracks it down. Almost stolen by Tam. Roberts kicks it out. Singh with two. One hangs. They won't get a shot off. Good defense by the Thunderwolves out of the timeout.
Yeah, I don't think that's the positive for the Gaels coming out of a timeout. Obviously, Stephen Berry would have liked to see better play after his instruction.
Harvey. It swung around. McIntosh. Bell was open inside. He does get the ball against Shoveler. Turns and scores.
Yep, Shoveler is definitely in tough, like you said, against the veteran.
And the interesting thing here is Stephen Berry's playing a hunch here. He's not going with Faulkner yet in this second quarter. If he could get through the first half with a double-digit lead and Greg Faulkner sitting on the bench with two fouls, I think he would take that in a second. Simpson drives on McIntosh. Floater, got it. Coach Erdman upset about the team's rotation on that, I think. Defensively, as we're into the last 3 minutes of the first half. Wainwright drives baseline. Shoveler cuts him off. Up top, Tam for three. Air ball. And the crowd will let him know. McKenzie. Nolan McKenzie checks in for Tam. Tam, the first-year player out of Vaughn, struggling here in this first half. Singh Drives, kicks it out. Simpson for three. No. Rebound, McKenzie. Hand off to Harvey. Harvey drives. He got a step on McKenzie Simpson and laid it in. Gaels quickly inbound. Lead back down to 14. Lencevic. He drives as the key open, turns, kicks it back out. Singh, he'll drive, cut off by McIntosh, five on the shot clock. Street swings it. Simpson, pull up jumper, got it. Good patience. They work the shot clock down. They're back up by 16. And Lakehead can't be upset about that. That was a good defensive stand. Wainwright got Street off his feet. Bell. Bell backing in Mislencevic. Baby hook, got it. That's a nice move. Back to 14 is the Gaels lead. Singh. And McKenzie Simpson moved. Singh thought he'd stay. And it's a turnover.
And head coach Stephen Berry of the Queens Gaels visibly upset about that turnover. Obviously, the Gaels want to keep the ball as much as possible, and free giveaways like that obviously won't be tolerated.
And Lakehead calls the timeout. It's a one timeout that they can't carry over to the second half. They might as well use it. 37-23, Gaels lead. But Lakehead with a possession coming up here, Peter, to cut into that lead, and you just get the sense that the veteran team of Lakehead feels okay in the position they're in. They haven't played great in the first half, yet the Gaels really haven't run away on them.
No, Lakehead's doing a good job of sticking around in this game, and they're not looking panicked at all, like you might see if they were a younger squad, but they're looking very composed on the floor, and they go out there, they run every offensive set like they have throughout the game, and they play hard defense every time on the other side of the ball. So the Gaels are definitely going to have to, you know, keep the tempo up if they want to continue, you know, the positives that they had in this quarter.
So out of the timeout, number 21 for Lakehead, Alexandra Robichaud, comes in, and Bell goes to the bench. So a smaller, possibly better shooting lineup in there with a minute 25 left for Lakehead. McIntosh kicks it out. Wainwright stripped, got it back, and put it in. Kept at it and got the bucket. Singh drives, kicks it out. Street, quick release, got it. You can't leave them open for a second.
No, that one only counts as two, but that was a deep two for Patrick Street, and he loves to shoot the ball from there.
They say his foot was on the line. So it's a 14-point lead again for the Gaels. Wainwright for three, misses, long rebound. Street can't get to it. Simpson can't get it. Harvey, McIntosh up, scores. And Lakehead's bench wants an intentional foul. 30 seconds left in the first half. 9 second differential between game and shot clock, and Mislencevic hits the three. McIntosh let him get open, and Coach Erdman is irate.
Yeah, again, the Gaels are just a great three-point shooting team, and it's when they're hitting those shots that they get leads like they do today.
Wainwright, cut off by Street. Wainwright drives, hangs, got it at the buzzer. No, they're going to say no basket. And Erdman, the coach of Lakehead, is halfway on the floor.
The basket's no good. All right, please make some noise and welcome back.
So the half ends with a lot happening, Peter. But the bottom line is Gaels are up 15, 42, 27.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like, if you just look at the score sheet, it looks like they've, you know, gradually gained from the 10-point lead after the first quarter to a 15-point lead after second quarter. But obviously a lot of swings in that second quarter that we saw.
So Gaels lead 42-27 at halftime. Peter and I are back with the second half in 10 minutes. You're watching Gaels Basketball live on QTV Sports.
It's really particularly special because it's our 30th. So if they canceled it on our 30th, that would have been pretty disappointing. So it's really wonderful, and we've had a great turnout from our classes, and it's been great.
Thank goodness, just in time. Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's all about Queen's spirit. That's what makes it so unique and interesting. Love it. Grab hold of every opportunity. Don't miss out on one single opportunity. Stay in touch. Laugh a lot. Yeah.
Enjoy your life.
Yeah.
Don't take anything for granted. Live every moment. You've got all sorts of opportunities, and don't worry too much about, you know, tomorrow. Live for today. It's time goes by fast, and you want to take advantage of every moment.
And the only thing I would add to that is be passionate. My wish would be that everybody could be passionate about a career they choose and love doing it every day. So find your passion and follow it, and let that be your guide.
Hold on.
I graduated 41 years ago, and also this year is my 40th in education. So I've been coming to home games here ever since then. We've had these seats almost for 35 years.
And although this wave is strange.
I'm glad it's back. I'm going to parade today with some of my classmates and so on.
Because I'm going to make this place.
I think just keep going as they are and think important things such as what they're going to do with their lives and what they're going to contribute to society and that. I think that's Queens. That's what Queens is about.
Don't pay no mind to the demon.
QTV would like to give a big thanks to the Student Life Center for their support in live streaming the Gaels games.
Hey Gaels, I'm Kesha Carlson, and this is your weekly sports update. In hockey this week, the men's team beat Laurentian 6-3. Taylor Clements had an impressive night for the Gaels by scoring 4 goals, 3 of which were in the third period. Braden Corbis added 3 assists to the Gaels' win. In women's hockey, the Gaels had a close but unfortunate loss to the York Lions in the 3-2 shootout. Claire McKellar finished with 1 assist to extend her point streak to 4 games, and Caitlin Mahonen stopped 31 shots in the game's close effort. In cross country, Gaels competed at the OUA Championships, and both the men's and women's team finished fourth. Victoria Coates finished in first place to win the OUA Championship women's race, while teammate Julianne Stolle took second. Jeff Archer led the way for the men's team with a fifth place finish. It was an exciting weekend for rugby, with the men's team winning the OUA semifinals with a 38-3 win over McMaster. The Gaels played a tough game yesterday, battling high winds and freezing temperatures. The Gaels put the first points on the board with a quick try by Brendan Sloan. Adam McQueen kicked the conversion following Sloan's try to give Queens an early 7-0 lead. Angus McPhail scored the second try for the Gaels after breaking through McMaster's back line. McQueen again kicked the conversion. In the 40th minute of the play, McMaster scored through a penalty goal. It was kicked by Andrew Ferguson, bringing the score 14-3 at the half. Queens gained a try from Dave Worsley just minutes into the second half. McQueen kicked another conversion. Minutes after Worsley's try, James Dent broke through the Marauders' defense, scoring another try for the Gaels. Dent's try was followed by Kenoya Lloyd's first try of the game. McQueen once again kicked the conversion, therefore successfully making 4-for-4. Lloyd closed the game for the Gaels with the second try of the match, bringing the Gaels to a 38-3 win over McMaster and advancing forward to the OUA Championship. The women's rugby team won their first OUA Championship title over Guelph with a score of 19-15. The Guelph Griffins were the first to put points on the board after a big run by Shannon Spurl into the try zone. Lindsay Ewan got the try to make it 5-0 in the first 5 minutes of play after a missed conversion by Guelph. The Gaels battled back, putting together a drive that got them into Griffin territory. Guelph took back possession, but Queens quickly regained the ball after a scrum. Queens pushed the ball into the try zone after being held up by the Griffins on their first attempt. Gaels player Bronwyn Corrigan jumped on the ball in the try zone, making it 7-5 after a successful conversion by Russell Division MVP Lauren McEwen. Queens player Kayla Root scored the Gaels' second try, which put the Gaels ahead 12-5 at the half. Root led the offense, scoring two tries for the Gaels. Corrigan scored the third try for Queens, and McEwen had two conversions, giving Queens 19 points overall. And this week's athletes of the week are Kayla Root from Peterborough, Ontario, and Taylor Clements, who scored the game winner. And next week's game of the week is men's rugby versus Western, where they are looking to extend their undefeated season and defend their title next Saturday at Nixon Field. My name is Kesha Carlson with QTD Sports. Check GoGalesGo.com for more updates.
I'm Danielle Bengel for QTV. Happy Halloween weekend to all those guys and ghouls out there. Here's what you missed during a crazy week 8. Kingston is a spooky city full of old and haunted buildings. Our Kingston Life team went out on the haunted walks last week to find out how ghost infested the city truly is. In arts and entertainment, we sat down with Colorado, an alternative rock group, after their show in Kingston to find out what it's like to truly be a rock and roller.
Hi, this is Menno from Colorado. You're watching Queens TV.
Our student life crew wanted to hear what students had to say about some important issues. They headed out to the student hub to hear what you had to say. This week, QTV's comedy segment explored horror in the technology age with their trailer for Tinder.
Holy shit!
From the mind of the chick who swears she thought of Scream 3 first, but didn't bother taking it to court.
Here at QTV, we got excited about Halloween a little early and accidentally went trick-or-treating throughout the hub. We got some unusual loot.
Trick-or-treat!
Every year, Engineers Without Borders does a pumpkin smash. Our student life team went out last week to see how it all goes down. Don't forget to check out our sports highlight reels to catch up on all your Gaels athletics news. Remember to come out to our Dead Sexy Halloween event this Saturday, November 2nd at the Underground. Come on out for dancing, signature drinks, costumes, and a scary good time. Links to all the segments you've seen here are easily accessible in the description box below. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook, Tumblr, Twitter, and Instagram at Queens TV for all your news and entertainment updates. I'm Danielle Bengel for QTV. Stay spooky, Queens.
It's really particularly special because it's our 30th. So if they canceled it on our 30th, that would have been pretty disappointing. So it's really wonderful, and we've had a great turnout from our classes, and it's been great.
Thank goodness, just in time. Yeah, definitely. I mean, it's all about Queen spirit. That's what makes it so unique and interesting. Love it. Grab hold of every opportunity. Don't miss out on one single opportunity. Stay in touch. Laugh a lot. Yeah.
Enjoy your life.
Yeah.
Don't take anything for granted. Live every moment. You've got all sorts of opportunities, and don't worry too much about, you know, tomorrow. Live for today. It's time goes by fast, and you want to take advantage of every moment.
And the only thing I would add to that is be passionate. My wish would be that everybody could be passionate about a career they choose and love doing it every day. So find your passion and follow it, and let that be your guide.
Graduated 41 years ago, and also this year is my 40th in education. So I've been coming to home games here ever since then. We've had these seats almost for 35 years. And although this wave is strange, I'm glad it's back. I'm going to parade today with some of my classmates and so on. Because I'm going to make this place. I think just keep going as they are, and think important things such as what they're going to do with their lives and what they're going to contribute to society and that. And I think that's Queens. That's what Queens is about. Don't pay no mind to the demon.
QTV would like to give a big thanks to the Student Life Center for their support in live streaming the Gaels games. QTV would like to give a big thanks to the Student Life Center for their support in live streaming the Gaels games.
Okay, and welcome back to the Queens Athletic and Recreation Center as we get set to start the second half. Bill Nichols along with Peter Reimer, the nightcap in our doubleheader here live on QTV Sports. The Gaels women winning earlier tonight against Lakehead, and now the men trying to do the same thing in their OUA regular season opener against the Thunderwolves. And they lead 42-27 at halftime, and Peter, the Gaels showing their style of play to Lakehead. They're going to hit those open threes if you give them to them, and then they're going to drive around you. Lakehead needs to maybe get back to their power game that they were trying to do early in the game.
Yeah, I think they had some success with that inside. I mean, especially when we saw the dunk to start the game, I thought that's maybe the way they were going to go, but getting back to that could get them back into the game.
So Lakehead starts with possession. Bell with the ball, joined by McIntosh, and misses the shot. It goes off the Gaels and out of bounds. McIntosh, Wainwright, Harvey, and Labov are the other starters for Lakehead. Singh, Faulkner, Roberts, Stroud, and Mislencevic for the Gaels. This is Harvey with the basketball. 15 on the shot clock. McIntosh kicks it out. Wainwright inside. Turnaround by Labov. Nice shot. Key for the Gaels is Faulkner's back on the floor. He did not play much due to foul trouble in the first half.
Roberts tries to find him there, and no luck as the cut is blocked off by the Lakehead player.
Faulkner, the only one of only two Gaels not to score. Mike Shoveler, the other one. The Gaels with nice balance scoring. Only four Thunderwolves scored in the first half for Lakehead. McIntosh, Bell, Harvey, and Wainwright. Harvey with the ball, goes up, can't hit, followed by Labov, followed by Harvey, hangs on the rim. Faulkner can't control, but they'll get the ball as it goes off Lakehead. Faulkner quickly down the other way, knocked out of bounds by Bell.
I like that the Gaels are trying to establish their tempo again off the bat here, moving the ball quickly down the floor.
Mislencevic almost lost the handle. Wants to turn, does on McIntosh. Nice move!
A great up and under there by Mislencevic. Something the Gaels sometimes struggle with is their straight up post play, seeing those post moves like that, but no problem there for Mislencevic.
Bell. Gaels back up by 15. Labov inside to McIntosh against Faulkner. Two on the shot clock. Wainwright forces up a three, and McIntosh is going to get a push into the back of Faulkner. And Coach Erdman is really working the officials now. Lakehead picking up full court. Mislencevic, and he'll bring it up the floor. And he's going to get an offensive foul with the off arm pushing.
Luckily for the Gaels, that's only his first foul of the game. So no trouble there. He can stay on the floor with that one.
Harvey. Bell sets a pick. They swing it around. Wainwright drives baseline, cut off. Going back around, Labov drives around Singh, pulls up, misses, and Stroud is going to get the foul this time as he pushed Bell down. That'll be three on Stroud.
Stroud's got to be a little more careful. I think everybody in the gym saw two hands on the Thunderwolves player.
Gaels sub number 23, Mike Shoveler, back on the court.
Wainwright to inbound. Up top to Harvey. Wainwright for three. Misses. Rebound Mislencevic. Harvey strips it from him. Labov. Wainwright again. He'll drive. Stolen by Singh. It was a bad pass, and then Wainwright tapped it back. Gaels wanted an over and back. Wainwright misses the three again. Faulkner with the rebound gets it to Mislencevic. That's an empty trip for Lakehead with plenty of opportunities. Roberts cut off by Wainwright. Comes back up top. Mislencevic. Drives. Tried to feed Singh instead of maybe taking the floater. And then Harvey loses it out of bounds.
Again, a lot of sloppy play to start this half, just as we saw to start the first half.
Singh. Shoveler. Hands off to Singh. Singh, a lot of dribbling, and now he's trapped. Bounces it off the leg of Harvey. Mislencevic gets it with 10 on the shot clock. Roberts drives over Wainwright. Got it. Not how Coach Barry drew it up, but he'll take the 2 points, and the Gaels equal or move their lead to 17. McIntosh. Wainwright from the foul line. Misses. Rebound. Shoveler. Singh. It's a 3-on-2 for the Gaels. Singh. Roberts. Stripped out of bounds by Harvey.
Out of bounds on Lakehead.
Nolan McKenzie will check in, I think, for Wainwright, but we'll see who comes off.
McKenzie's back in the game.
It is for Wainwright. Shoveler up top to Mislencevic. Singh gets a step on McKenzie. Layup. Too quick for McKenzie, I think.
Yeah, Singh's got quick feet and those long arms to reach all the way to the basket there.
And Tam may be coming in now to try his hand. And Faulkner ahead of everyone. Dunks it home. Gaels lead by 19. Lakehead needs a timeout.
Now both teams have a two-handed dunk down at that end of the court. Faulkner really getting the crowd back into it with that one.
And it sets the Gaels' biggest lead of 21 in this game. Forces Lakehead to call a timeout.
And now please welcome back and make some noise for your Green Stance team.
And it came off that pressure defense that we've been seeing Lakehead try to do, but the Gaels get the steal and Faulkner goes down the other way.
Yeah, the Gaels guards are really good with their hands, and that's something you'll see a lot from Roshane Roberts and Sukhpreet Singh, their ability to get in there and steal the ball away from opposing guards.
The struggle still for Lakehead at the offensive end. What do you think they need to do? It almost looked like they had their heart set on trying to get Faulkner to pick up a third foul with McIntosh and maybe got out of their offensive set.
Yeah, I think they have to go back to the power that they had to start the game. Look for the, I mean, their big guys do have a couple fouls, but I think they got to get them back into the game and look to get them the ball and just work Queens, you know, work the angle with the height advantage that they have.
So 5:58, the time left, third quarter, and the Gaels lead by 21. They led by 15 when we started this third quarter. They've outscored Lakehead by an 8-7 score. LeBob inside to Bell. Bell turns on Shoveler and scores. It's too strong for Mike Shoveler.
Yeah, that's one thing that you'll see a lot in first year, especially first year post players, is that they're always smaller than the rest of the post players in the league.
Steal by the Lakehead press, and they draw a foul from Mackenzie Simpson. So out of the timeout, Lakehead with a bucket, a steal, and now trying to make it back-to-back scores. The ball swings to Harvey. Harvey. He'll drive. Tam for three. No. Rebound and a strong one by McIntosh. Goes back up. Misses. And the Gaels come away. Empty trip again for Lakehead. Singh. Roberts. Three. Got it!
Gaels' two favorite things to do on offense there, run the ball and shoot the three. Doing both well there.
And now the Gaels lead by 22. Every time it looks like Lakehead's gaining some momentum, the Gaels quell it. Bell kicks it out to Tam, swung around to Harvey. McIntosh turns on Faulkner. Tips in his miss. Simpson comes up with it, trying to get through the hands, got it out to Singh, and the Gaels come away 4-on-3. Lakehead catches up. Singh drives, and he was pushed. Won't be on the shot, so the Gaels will inbound. Roberts. Tam doing a good job moving his feet. Shoveler shot from the free throw line too strong. Lakehead will take that offensive set from the Gaels all night. Harvey drives, goes up, and Shoveler fouled him. And that'll be three on Mike.
Not a good sequence there for Shoveler. After he misses the 15-foot jumper and commits a foul at the other end of the floor.
A rookie out of Armfryer, son of a former great Gale, is learning university basketball is not the same as high school. Harvey makes the first.
Harvey's all by the way.
This is the second. Faulkner has it stripped by Labov, and it's out of bounds off Labov. The Gaels will retain possession with a 21-point lead. Full court press by Lakehead, looking for something to ignite them. Simpson again trapped. They go right into that trap, but this time Simpson gets it to Singh. Singh up top. Faulkner, beautiful pass to Mislintsevich.
That really showcases Faulkner's athleticism there. He might not be scoring, but he's getting Gale's points still.
He's only 2 points of the game, the dunk that brought the crowd to their feet. Tam drives, cut off. Mislintsevich tried to draw the charge. They don't give it to him, and Tam scores the bucket. Roberts spins and gives it to Singh. Faulkner drives. Mislintsevich turns, kicks it out. Roberts for three, and Tam fouled him. And Roberts will get three free throws. Passlebar and Mavity will check in for the Gaels. Koch will check in for Lakehead. Out goes McIntosh as Lakehead will go smaller. Singh will come out. And Roberts will come out, so we'll see how the Gaels do without their two outstanding guards against what is obviously going to be a more intense press by Lakehead as they bring on more quickness to take off the size of McIntosh.
Yeah, I think here it'll be Packlebar taking the dribbling duties for the Gaels as he's the main ball handler over Mavity.
Roberts gets all three free throws, and the Gaels now lead by 24 points. 3:20 and counting left third quarter. Tam. Harvey. Labov spins, gets the lane, and scores. Mavity, nobody traps him, and he brings it up. Faulkner almost fumbled that pass. Mislintsevich swings it to Simpson. Simpson drives on Koch, almost puts a bucket in. Koch wonders what the foul's for, but it did look like he pushed Simpson with his body, and McKenzie will go to the line for two.
Simpson will shoot two.
Yeah, Simpson almost finishing from behind the backboard, reaching around there, but unfriendly roll.
Simpson misses the first.
Simpson last year was actually the Gaels' worst free throw shooter, but their second best three-point shooter.
We'll figure that stat.
Yeah.
Hits one of two. Gaels are back up by 23. Harvey fumbling with the ball a bit. Tam. Stolen by Simpson. Poor pass by Tam. Simpson drives, lays it in. And the lead is 25. It continues to grow. As Coach Erdman looks for something to get his Lakehead team going. Labov hits the corner jump shot. Mavity in trouble, threw it away. Tam, Koch for three, no, rebound Harvey, Koch again for three, no, Labov, and he was fouled by Simpson. Good sequence there by Igor Labov.
That last possession for Lakehead set up by Mavity giveaway. That is an area that you'll see the Gaels lacking in is when they have Roshane Roberts and Sukhpreet Singh on the bench. Their point guard position lacks a bit of composure.
They are a much different team to press when Roberts and Singh, as you say, Peter, are not on the floor. Labov hits the first. He makes this one, it's a 21-point game. With a little under 2 minutes left, third quarter. Faulkner almost traveled in. And you wonder how long Singh and Roberts can stay on the bench. Stephen Barry doesn't want to have to do it. But right now, his team is struggling, and Lakehead's gaining some momentum. Tam drives, lane opens up, he scores, and now it's a 19-point game. Faulkner almost traveled again. He'll bring it over the timeline. He'll drive, and then turn it back, and almost stolen by Labov. Pack Labov. Labov really hustling on defense. Faulkner. And he stepped out of bounds, and the Gaels are rattled and might need a timeout. Instead of a timeout, Singh and Roberts return.
Yeah, head coach Stephen Barry obviously looking for more composure on the floor and opts to put on his more experienced guards rather than calling a timeout in that situation.
Tam drives, layup, misses. Wallace puts in the rebound. It's 17 points the deficit now. And a 7-0 run by Lakehead. 1 minute left, third quarter. Roberts, floater, misses. Rebound, Lakehead on the floor. And Roberts will get the foul. Lakehead will go to the line with bonus and a chance to get even closer.
This is really quite a collapse we've seen in the last few minutes by the Gaels. It just seems like their defense is, I don't know, it seems like they've lost focus on defense. And Lakehead's finding lanes a lot easier than they have in the rest of the game.
And really set off, Peter, by some good intensity by Igor Labov. He's made the buckets, and he's done things at the defensive end.
Yeah, he's been able to find people with his passes, and he's been putting the ball in himself.
Robichaud hits the first. If he makes this one, it's a 9-0 Lakehead run, and the Gaels' lead will be down to 15. Make it so. Singh almost thrown away by Faulkner. The Gaels are a little rattled, and Singh lost the ball. Lakehead possession. And they're going to talk about it. And Coach Erdman will lose his ever-loving mind, I would think, if this gets reversed.
He's already unhappy, you can tell, just with the refs conferring on the call.
And I think his complaint is that the referee from outside came in, and that's the right thing to do. They talked. Oh, and now the call got changed back. So 16 on the shot clock after all that. Gaels will inbound. Faulkner drives, hangs, doesn't score, and then he gets his third foul. So in the end, Lakehead's going to get the ball and a chance to get to within 13 or 12 here. And it'll be bonus because of the foul. So Pope goes to the line for two.
Gail sub, number six, Kenzie Simpson back in the game.
Faulkner will come out with his third foul as he discusses it with the official. He hasn't liked two of his three fouls. Coke hits the first. It's a 10-0 Lakehead run. They were trailing 61-37. But since then, they've scored 11 in a row, and they're within 13. And it's been because of this press that's finally starting to pay some dividends. 40 seconds left in the third quarter. Singh pulls it out. Stroud, Street, Simpson. Nice play on the offense. And the Gaels end the 11-0 run.
Yeah, getting the ball inside works for the Gaels. Something they haven't done yet in the game, mostly shooting from the outside so far.
2 second difference between game and shot clock. Cam pulls it out. Wants a pick set. Here it comes from Wallace. Stroud hedges out. Lobov for three over Simpson. Got it! And the clock will expire. And at after three quarters, the Gaels lead, which was once 24, gets shaved in half to 12. And it's 63-51. And here's what the visitors wanted, Peter. The fourth quarter and being in striking distance, and they've got that.
They do. And that's one of the things that we talked about in the first half. They have their composure, and they haven't panicked at all in their position in the game. Even down 24 points, they didn't scramble at all. They really just kept with the press. That worked a little bit for them. Their head coach, Matt Erdman, really sticking to the press, and eventually it just started to pay off a little bit at a time, and now they're right back into the game.
And as we mentioned, it was a 25-point lead with about 3.5-4 minutes left in this third quarter. And Lakehead goes on a 14-2 run and gets the lead down to 12. 15-2 run, make that. And it's 63-51. And you see now why the Thunderwolves were one of the top teams in the country last year and why they're a contender again this year over on the in that West Division, which has a lot more parity probably than the East, where it's Carleton and the rest of the world. Yeah. In the West, it's Windsor, Western, Lakehead, McMaster, Brock, sort of all fighting for that top spot.
Yeah, it's true. The East really gets jammed, and Queens is a little bit unfortunate in their position here. They're trying to rise up, you know, and build their team into, you know, maybe not a Carleton, but maybe something like Ryerson or something who really developed in the last few years into a top team.
The Gaels hoping to get someday to where Carleton is with this young team that's gaining experience by the game. Last year made a great leap forward. And this year would like to repeat that. They lead by 12 here as we start the fourth quarter, and the Gaels have the ball. Roberts over Lobov, taller defender, and he missed the shot. And here comes Lakehead again. Chance to get to within 10 or into single digits with a three. Cope swung around. Robichaud, Cam open for three. Misses. Lobov with the rebound and scores. It's a 10-point Gaels lead. Singh. Into the front court. Gives it to Roberts. Faulkner will come in for the Gaels' next stoppage, but right now the Gaels need a bucket. Mackenzie Simpson turns, fouled by Coates.
One stat that's really turned around throughout the game is the total rebounds for the team. Now Lakehead's all the way back into the game, and they're leading the rebounding battle 25-22.
And the Gaels with 9 third quarter turnovers, which helped Lakehead make that comeback. And the scoring has become more balanced from Lakehead in that third quarter. Simpson hits one of two, the lead back to 11. Ms. Lencevich comes in for Simpson. Faulkner had checked into the game during the first free throw for Street. So the starters are on for the Gaels. Tam. Cope. Swung around, LeBob. Drives, blocked by Stroud, Roberts. Wanted to push it up, but good work by Robichaud to slow him down. Singh. Faulkner. Stroud. They'd like to take advantage of Faulkner on Coates. Singh spins, falls. And Faulkner makes the steal on a bad pass. Roberts. Drives. Knocked out of bounds by LeBob. Been very impressed with Igor LeBob in this second half.
Yeah, he's played defense intentionally and been able to find his way to the basket on offense.
Early fourth quarter, Gaels had led by 25 at one point in the third quarter. Now only lead by 11. Roberts drives, hangs, no call, and it goes off of Roberts, but hits the Lakehead player. That's out of bounds.
A bit of an unlucky play there for Robichaud as he's sitting on the out-of-bounds line as when the ball lands on his lap.
As Lencevich wanted to hand off to Singh. Instead, he's going to try and turn on Robichaud. Does, and draws a foul from Robichaud. It's a matchup that was going to be tough for Robichaud from the get-go once Milencevic set himself and started to go down, and now I believe Coach Erdman is going to get his last warning from referee John Besling. And the next time they talk to him, it would be with a technical foul. As Lencevich misses the first one. Gaels can't start missing free throws now that this game's gotten close. But that's what they do. They miss them both. Rebound comes to Faulkner, and he gets fouled by Wallace, who thought he got all ball. And Coach Erdman is doing everything in his power to stay seated to his seat.
Yeah, you can sometimes get away with two or three last warnings from the referees if you space them out enough, but two in a row like that wouldn't do him well right now.
Faulkner hits both. Gaels are back up by 13. LeBob fumbled the ball a bit. Trying to get Wallace open inside. Six on the shot clock. Tam drives, kicks it out. LeBob for three, but he stepped out of bounds.
I think that was a good defensive set there for the Gaels. Really getting the pressure on the Lakehead Thunderwolves there and not allowing the players inside to get open.
Singh to Stroud, Zlencevic. Roberts now being guarded by Koch. Zlencevic again against Robichaud, and that's a charge. Robichaud did a good job. He set that one up with the foul call before.
He definitely had his feet planted there, but I think the crowd reflecting the attitude that maybe went down a little bit easier than he should have.
Tam spins on Roberts. Ball loose on the floor. LeBob comes up with it. Cope thought about the long distance three. 10 on the shot clock, and Singh will get the reach. He got the ball, but he did look like he got a bit of LeBob in the process. It's those long arms of Singh. Sometimes get him fouls he doesn't think he should get.
Yeah, he always can get his hand in there to get the ball, but it's a question of whether he can get it out in time to avoid the foul call.
So Lakehead with 14 on the shot clock. Tam. Robichaud inside to Wallace. Wallace turns, They want to foul this Lakehead. They don't get it. And one thinks in a couple of minutes, Mount Erdman may blow if the calls don't start coming his way. Faulkner open inside, lays it in. Great cut. The ball got picked off. Lakehead will call a timeout. As the lead is back up to 15, which is what it was at halftime.
Yeah, I think the Gaels have to be happy with how they've started off this fourth quarter, not giving Lakehead as much as they gave them in the third quarter.
And welcome back. 68-53 is our score. In the fourth quarter, again, a reminder, Peter and I will be back with you tomorrow night. 8 o'clock tip-off time, the men's basketball team in action again here from the Queens Athletic and Recreation Center live on QTV Sports against the Guelph Griffins. It will be a Saturday of Griffins against Gaels. It starts in the afternoon at 1 with a football game, OUA Yates Cup semifinal at Richardson Stadium, Queens and Guelph, and then women's men's basketball doubleheader right here live on QTV. Myself and Rachel Morosevic for the women's game at 6, and then Peter will join me for the men's game after that. 6:42 time left in the fourth quarter. Gaels up by 15. Lakehead to inbound, and they've got one timeout left. And you saw that in the women's game, and timeouts are vitally important with FIBA rules. Nice pass by Harvey inside to Labov out of the timeout. That's a great play call by Coach Erdman. Singh. Hands off to Ms. Lencevic. Robichaud trying to strip it from Ms. Lencevic, who floats, just throws it up. Stroud got the rebound, Robichaud the foul.
Ryle Stroud doing a good job there, getting inside position, grabbing that rebound as it came down.
And Stroud uses every part of the rim to get that first free throw. Doesn't get the help of the rim on the second one, and the lead is 14. Harvey, nice drive to the hoop. Stroud fouls him, count the hoop. Probably a foul Ryle Stroud didn't need because Harvey had already gotten to the hoop, but now a chance to get to within 11.
Especially considering his position with fouls, that's his fourth. As he picks that one up, one more.
I think for the Gaels, it's better than Faulkner getting his fourth, but Lakehead's certainly starting to assert themselves offensively here in the fourth quarter. And with about 6 minutes left in the fourth quarter, they're back to within 11. Roberts. Stroud. Mislencevic. Faulkner wanted it inside. Gets it inside with 5 on the shot clock. Feels for Labov. Fadeaway. Got it. That's a tough shot. Labov couldn't do much more than that. Tam drives, gets the layup. Singh upset with himself for losing Henry Tam. Roberts into the front court, pulls it back out. Gaels don't want to get cautious now. Still plenty of time left. And Faulkner stepped out of bounds.
Gaels out of bounds.
And a chance for the second time in the second half for the Thunderwolves.
Bit of confusion there as the scores
table. I think the Gaels had called a timeout, and they got the timeout. Lakehead thought they'd already inbounded the ball, and so the timeout shouldn't have been rewarded. So everybody's getting a little anxious now as we get into the fourth quarter. Lakehead will have a possession coming up to get to within single digits for the first time since the first quarter. And Peter, considering where this game was midway through the third quarter,
yeah.
The Gaels, are a young team, are starting to feel the pressure, you would think.
Yeah, that's one of the areas where the Gaels lack. It's not in skill, but in their experience in these kinds of situations. Obviously, they were able to get the lead, but maintaining it was a problem. And being able to play through the last, you know, the last 5 minutes of this game.
Should mention as well that the women's rugby team at Queens has advanced to the semifinal at the national championships tomorrow afternoon at the University of Laval. They'll play the third-ranked Alberta Golden Bears at 1:30, and you can watch that live on your computer at cis-sic.tv. So again, that's the women's semifinal at the CIS Rugby Championships. The Gaels hoping to follow up their OUA banner of a week ago with a national championship. Back to action as we approach the midway point of the fourth quarter, and Lakehead with a chance to get to within single digits. Tam drives, hangs, no, Wallace follows, and there you go. First time since the first quarter, and it's now a 9-point lead. Singh being hounded by Harvey. Almost a turnover by Singh. Mislencevic against Labov, got him in the air, hangs and scores. That was great patience.
Yeah, he was able to beat the shorter man and then wait out the big guy.
Tam. Robichaud. Wallace fighting for position with Stroud. Harvey for three. No, rebound Stroud. Good defensive possession by the Gaels. Singh to Stroud to Faulkner. Don't want to leave Faulkner open for a three. Mlencevic wants it inside. Wallace cuts him off. Kicks it out. Singh for three. Short. Faulkner got the rebound, but missed the bunny. Might have been well advised to bring it back out. Tam the other way. Stolen by Singh. Gaels the other way. And Singh will pull it out. Under four left in regulation. Mlencevic. Roberts. Faulkner drives, lays it in. Great pick set by Stroud.
2 points.
Labov drives, feeds Wallace. Great play by Faulkner to steal it. Singh from Roberts drives, hangs, scores.
This is what the Gaels have been looking for the last quarter and a half. This kind of quickness back and forth on the floor, high tempo defense, causing turnovers, getting the ball, and finishing quickly at the other end.
Lakehead calls their last time out of the game as it gets back up to a 15-point lead. And we're into the final third of this fourth quarter. Coach Erdman needs to bring back that pressure defense, I would think.
Yeah, that is what gave them success earlier in the game, is that pressure defense. It didn't result in points right away, so I'd be curious if they can apply the pressure to make it work, you know, right out of this timeout.
It's been interesting. Lakehead, Peter, has gone with a smaller lineup most of his second half. They brought Wallace in, but really, McIntosh hasn't played much in the second half. Bell hasn't played much. And they've gone with the smaller lineup. Labov has done a great job. But you wonder if maybe McIntosh comes back into the game.
Yeah, he was definitely a threat for them earlier in the game. And it seemed a little bit like they're trying to play Queen's game, in the sense that they had a shorter lineup on the floor and they were looking to beat the Gaels with their quickness.
One of the referees just got a happy birthday. I think it was called to the PA by one of the other officials. So Lakehead to inbounds, down 15, 3:26, and counting the time left in regulation. Harvey, and McIntosh is back into the game. He replaces Wallace. Inside to Labov. Kicks it back out. McIntosh thought about the three. Returns it to Labov. Can't hit. Goes back up. Stroud might have got away with his fifth. Gaels come away with the basketball. Singh. An East foul by Harvey. Singh might have rolled his ankle a little bit. He tries to shake that out. And that's going to be the second on Harvey. No one in real foul trouble for Lakehead. Singh hits the first. Robert, Singh, and Faulkner, probably the three best foul shooters on the basketball team. So it's good to have Singh at the line.
Definitely these last 3 minutes could come down to a lot of foul shots.
And with 3 minutes left, it's back up to a 17-point Gaels lead. Gaels on a 6-0 run right now. Make that an 8-0 run. And another Lakehead turnover. Roberts drives. What a great move! And it's a 19-point lead.
Bit of a hesitation.
And
move.
Another steal. Singh with a spin. Singh. Roberts. Oh, it's looking nice if you're a Gaels fan right now.
Lakehead out of timeouts, and Gaels just rolling on this momentum.
And another steal, but Milencevic couldn't handle it, and it goes out of bounds. But with 2:17 left, the Gaels may have weathered the final foray by the visitors. Street will come on. Roberts will come on. This is interesting. Maybe to put more height on Wainwright, who's checked in for Lakehead, a three-point shooter. Harvey drives, blocked out of bounds by Mislencevic. Six on the shot clock for Lakehead.
I think head coach Stephen Berry might be feeling a little more comfortable with a 21-point lead here, putting Street in so he can, you know, feel the pressure. He hasn't had this kind of experience in this kind of situation yet.
12-0 run in the last 2 minutes for the Gaels. Ended on McIntosh's jump hook there. As we get into the last 2 minutes of regulation, Faulkner into the front court. When will Lakehead start to foul? Mislencevic. They swing it around. Street. Up to Singh, and they'll just pull it out. 10 on the shot clock. Singh. Drives. Hangs. Puts it up. Won't fall, but it used up all the shot clock. And with 98 seconds left and a 19-point lead, Lakehead's got to score in a hurry. And Wainwright misses the three. Stroud gets the rebound. Singh into the front court. Still no foul by Lakehead. Singh a little out of control, and they're going to call a block on Robichaud. So Singh will get bailed out on that one.
Yeah, he was definitely out of control. Looked like all the way from half court dribbling in there. Bit of a lucky call for him.
Number 23, Mike Shuffler.
Lakehead led 2-0. The Gaels took a 4-2 lead and have never trailed. They have led by as many as 25 points and now lead by 19. Their lead was 15 at halftime as Singh hits the first. Misses the second. So it'll stay 84-64. Harvey. Swung around. Wainwright to Labov. Labov, nice spin on Shoveler, who came from behind to block it. Kept alive. Singh comes away with it. And I think maybe just pull it out. No, he'll give it to Simpson. Tried to feed Shoveler, and it got knocked out of bounds. With exactly a minute left, Singh will come out. Paklavar will come in. And in for the first time, Brandon Licata will take out Robichaud. As I think the Thunderwolves are throwing up the white flag. And we'll get ready to go to York for their game tomorrow night when the Gaels host Guelph. Street. Mavity, who checked in. Cross court, Simpson for three, no, rebound, Shoveler had it knocked out of bounds by Labov, so it'll stay clean and low with 45.3 seconds left. So Lakehead goes to York tomorrow night to play the Lions. Gaels will host Guelph tomorrow night here at the Arc. We'll have both games for you right here on QTV. Shoveler's pass across court, hits the rim.
I guess there are disadvantages to being 6'11".
McIntosh. And it. Niketa. McIntosh again. Wainwright for three. Misses. Simpson with the rebound. Shot clock is off. And the Gaels will be able to run this one out. Gaels will move to 1-0. The season opens with a win. Next up is a meeting with Guelph. The coaches will shake at midcourt. Good friends, Erdman and Barry. The Gaels win 84-64, and it's a clean sweep tonight for Queens in basketball. And Peter, some final comments. We saw the Gaels at their best, but we also saw their youth and immaturity show up late in that third quarter, early fourth quarter, but they were able to weather the storm, and they win the game.
Yeah, I think how good the Gaels are going to be this year is going to depend on how much of the game they can play at their peak. If they can play that well for the full 40 minutes, then they're going to be contenders with just about everybody in the league.
So the Gaels win 84-64. The women's basketball team wins their game as well. Peter and I will be back tomorrow night with the men's game. That'll be following the women's game with myself and Rachel Orosovic calling that action. For Peter Reimer, for Rachel Orosovic, and the entire QTV sports crew, I'm Bill Miklas. We'll see you tomorrow night. It's Griffin's Gaels tomorrow night. You've been watching men's and women's basketball live on QTV.
Also, World Camera, Richardson Stadium. Thank you for coming out. Have a safe drive home.